As it is, the provision of the Constitution has spoken. There cannot be an addendum or another reopening of the case at the lower court, its jurisdiction having lapsed. My noble lords, I've taken time to state the law on the issue to show the futility of this motion. It cannot be granted. The jurisdiction of this court is donated by the Constitution and the Electoral Act regarding election petition appeals. We do not have the virus to admit this disposition, and we cannot invoke Section 22 of the Supreme Court Act, since the lower court has since lost its jurisdiction. More so, there is no paragraph of the petition to accommodate a case of forgery. Again, the appellants have distilled 7 issues for the determination of this appeal, and none relates to certificate forgery. One wonders what the appellants intended to do with the deposition, since appeals are heard on the issues distilled for determination by the parties in this court. In Saliba and Jason, 2002, for Nigeria Willow Report, citations others supplied, this court stated clearly that all appeals are decided upon the issues formulated for determination. What this means is that any matter not covered by any issue for determination is of no moment. Should the deposition be admitted, it will float in the appeal, as this court cannot exercise original jurisdiction even if we are to start a new case for the appellants. See Sanusi and Ayula, Chitex Industries and Oceanic Bank, citations supplied. Finally, my noble lords, on this application, I wish to state that fresh evidence is not received as a matter of course. There are conditions which must coexist before the court can grant this type of application, as can be garnered from the decided authorities of this court, which include, that's all right, but not limited to Omu Buariri and others, and Igbo Oyosi and others, Supra, Adebite and Emotion, cases cited by the senior counsel by the second respondent. Simply put, the conditions for the grant of this type of application are that one, the fresh evidence could not have been obtained with reasonable diligence at the trial. Two, such evidence, if admitted, would have important effect on the subject of the appeal. Three, such evidence ex facie is apparently capable of being believed. Four, such evidence would have influenced the judgment of the lower court in favor of the appellants, had it been available. And five, and if such evidence is admitted, further evidences from the opposing party would not be needed. Taking the first condition, for example, the appellants failed to convince this court on why it waited until after the court below delivered judgment in the petition and lost the 180 days donated to it by the Constitution before bringing the said deposition sought to be admitted in this court. It has to be noted that appeals are a continuation of hearing of the matter in the lower court. As was pointed out by the learned senior counsel for the first respondent, A.B. Mahmoud S.A., the presidential election was conducted on the 25th of February, 2023. And the first respondent declared the second respondent as winner of the election on 1st March, 2023. Thereafter, the appellants filed their petition at the registry of the court below on 21st March, 2023. If I may ask, what attempts did the appellants make between the publication of the second respondent's form EC-9 and accompanying documents in June 2022, a year, more than a year ago, and the date of filing the petition on 21st of March 2023 to obtain the documents from Chicago State University, which could have been used at the trial court? Again, what attempts did the appellants make to obtain these documents between the date of filing the petition and the conclusion of trial? To say the least, The above questions are critical in the quest of this court's efforts to decide whether the new evidence sought to be adduced could have been obtained by the appellants with reasonable diligence for use at the trial. And with due respect to the appellants and their counsel, I think they were a bit tardy and were not reasonably diligent in their attempts at obtaining the documents which they seek to have this court seek in this appeal. In Adeleke Aserifa Asupra, this court held that where the evidence is available and could with reasonable care and diligence be made available to the applicant at the time of the trial, as in this case, the court should refuse to exercise its discretion to receive such evidence. From all I have stated above, it is crystal clear that the additional evidence by way of deposition or oath does not fit into the issues submitted for the determination of this appeal. The application, my lord, of the appellant applicants in the circumstance is hereby refused and accordingly dismissed. I now go to the main appeal. I want to say that the motions filed by the respondents to challenge some issues, grounds of appeal, we have decided to ignore them, strike them out, and hear the appeal on the merits. The latest senior counsel for the appellants distilled seven issues for determination, all of them except the last one. The third respondent submitted six issues. So we have stated all the seven issues in the judgment. You will see them when you get copies. There is no doubt that all the issues submitted by all the parties are similar, and any could be adopted for guidance. I propose, however, to determine this appeal based on the issues as formulated by the appellants. After all, it is their own appeal. Issue one. The thrust of issue one is whether the lower court was right in refusing to hold that the failure of the first respondent to electronically transmit results from polling units nationwide for the collation of results introduced by the Electoral Act 2022 and specified in the regulations and guidelines for the conduct of elections 2022 and manual for election officials 2023 does not amount to non-compliance, which substantially affected the outcome of the election. Chief Krisuche, S.A., learned senior counsel for the appellants, submitted in the main that by virtue of section 64, sub 4 of the Electoral Act 2022, the collation officers and returning officers of the first respondent, including the national chairman of the first respondent, were under a statutory obligation towards mandatory verifications and confirmations at all stages required before the announcement of the results of the election. Blenesuk further contended that at the trial of the appellant's subpoenaed witnesses, several ANEC presiding officers, including PW 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 23, 24, and 25, who handled the BWAS machines at the polling units on the election day, who confirmed the non-transmission of results of the presidential election electronically from the BWAS machines, whereas transmitted without difficulty, that the appellant's witnesses gave evidence that the bypass of the use of the prescribed verification technology was nationwide, affecting the entire polling units and collation, and substantially affected the outcome of the election. That the sole witness of the first respondent, Lawrence Biode, admitted under cross-examination that the deployment of the technology of BWAS and IREV was to guarantee the transparency of the electoral process and the integrity of the results, but claimed that there was a technical glitch that made the system fail to work on the election day, which technical glitch was not explained by the first respondent. The appellant contended that the failure to transmit the result electronically led to manipulation of the results in favor of the second respondent. Lenessel then urged this court to depart from its previous decisions pursuant to that 6 Rule 254 of the Supreme Court rules on the manner of proof of non-compliance with the provisions of the Electoral Act in the light of the novel provision in Section 132 of the Act and paragraph 46 of 4 of the first schedule to the Electoral Act. The SN submitted that the assurances given to the public by the first respondents as a public institution that results will be electronically transmitted was dashed. It is his contention that the election ought to be nullified by reason of the gross misrepresentation by the first respondent based on the doctrine of legitimate expectation as applied by this court in Stitch and AG Federation, citation supplied. The learned soul concluded on this issue that given the introduction of technology into the collation process by the new Electoral Act 2022, the judicial approach and the attitude must of necessity be different from the analog past. He then invites this court to depart from its decisions on mode of proof of non-compliance with the Electoral Act in election petitions, as was the case in Nyesom Wike and Peterson, Okereke and Umahi Shinkafi and Yari, amongst others. He urged the counsel for the first respondent, the court to decline the invitation to override his previous decision for such his appeal, relying on VP Industries Limited and Cocoa Industries Limited, citation supplied. Contended that the appellant has not contended that the previous decisions sought to be departed from were
experience the smooth and strong feeling that consistently surpasses expectation. Leading the way in high-performance lubricants, Master Supermotor Oil is as durable as titanium. Experience the smooth and strong feeling that consistently surpasses expectation. Leading the way in high-performance lubricants.